Hey there, and welcome to another video about Softr and all of its amazing features. In this video, we're going to be covering the SEO features that we have here in Softr. Naturally, Softr websites load fast, as they're backed by AWS powerful hosting, and the faster they are, the higher on those search rankings you're going to be. So you can feel confident in your website's rankings based off of the speed alone using Softr. Something else that's really nice is some of their tools do not do this, which I honestly have no idea why, but Softr compresses your images automatically when you upload them to the app that you have, and that's going to make your websites load even quicker on a slower connection. When jumping into any application, something else that's really great for SEO is the fact that these are responsive apps. You have the ability to change the view here in the editor, which shows what it would look like on your desktop, your tablet, and on mobile. This view allows you to really see how your app's gonna stack up in comparison to other ones when you're on different viewing experiences. On any page, what you can do from an SEO perspective is if you go to the page settings and then press the three dots, go to settings, you can adjust the SEO right here by adjusting the title, meta description. Choose whether you want to have search engine indexing on or off. I would definitely recommend that you do for most things. And also whether you want to adjust the canonical URL, which helps with duplicative pages. Another awesome feature within Softr is the fact that you can set tags for your images and meta tags for headers and subheaders within the software. So by going to the homepage in your app, you then can click on this header and it will allow you to, for example, change this text to say inventory track, which adds another layer of SEO to your pages. Now you can do the exact same thing for subheaders, as you can see here. It allows you to add a image alt text for any images you have set as well. So something else that's really amazing for lists is if we go into a list page and then we go to the settings here and then SEO, you can see that there is an option here to click a guide that talks about list details within Softr. In order to define these different SEO settings, you're gonna have to do that within your data source, whether that be Google Sheets or Airtable. So if I go into my Airtable, and if I go into my inventory tracking and find the table that matches this one, so this is gonna come from the product inventory table. So we go to product inventory. I then can add some of these specific parameters. As you can see, there's SEO index, SEO slug, title, and description. For example, I'm just gonna take this, add a field that's just a single line text. I'm gonna call it field name SEO index. I'm gonna add the other ones as well that we had on this page. So SEO slug, title, and description. So I'm gonna go one by one, just add these as single line text, followed by SEO title, and then adding a SEO description. Now, after you set this up, essentially what you can do is implement specific information. For example, you can add a slug to this product. So we have a pair of headphones right here. So we can add a slug index and all these things. So let's do index for the one and then call it Apple Watch Series 4 for the slug. And then I'll do Apple Watch Series 4. Or the SEO title, and then jot in a description of an Apple Watch Series 4. So the Apple Watch Series 4 is a best in class smartwatch superstar. And you actually don't need to do anything in your Softr app, right? This is gonna allow you to add all of these different SEO components to this page without needing to do anything. Absolutely no worries on your end from needing to go in here and go into the page settings, as this is just going to keep saying that you can define the SEO settings for each record within your data source. Now, when it comes to SEO configurations from an overall setting standpoint, you just go to settings here and then SEO. And what you'll see is the ability to turn on heading tag settings. So for example, just like you did with the metadata earlier, you can add different heading tags for things like H1, H2, and H3s for block tiles and section titles of static feature blocks. This setting section in general though is where you can take control of your website and connect it to Google Search Console. This is also where you could allow the robots.txt to get put onto your site so that you can tell search engines to crawl for it, and more specifically, not just the whole website, but as you can see here, it'll tell search engine crawlers which pages can or can't be requested from your website. You're also able to change any URL redirects here. So if you had an old path, you can change it to the new one. And this will set up 301 redirects, which are very useful as well. Now, similar to SEO, there's also in the settings section an analytics portion. So if we go to integrations, you can see we do have a couple tools like Fathom Analytics, Google Analytics, and Hotjar, which simply just need for you to copy something like your Google Analytics ID and then paste it into your app, and then you're up and running. The exact same thing with Hotjar and other tools as well, like Fathom. As you can see, Softr is fully packed with different SEO integrations, tools, and different ways that you can make sure that you are fully optimized for all of your SEO needs. If you like this video and want to see more on what we're doing in Softr, make sure to check out videos like this one on how to improve your Softr skills even more.